Hey folks, in this video, I have some big news to share with you. Firstly, I'm moving, and secondly, I think I know what camera system I'm going to buy into. So firstly, yes, I have made the decision. My family and I, we're moving out of America, but there's three things I need to get clear from the outset. One, this isn't like taking a stand or something. We've had a fantastic and productive time in America. Secondly, this isn't directly tied to the election. I'm actually filming this a week before the voting day. And thirdly, it's not like I'm just disappearing and gone for good. I'm actually intending to split my time between a few different countries as we go forward. So, the move is actually underway already. As I film this, my wife flew out a week ago. She's arrived safely. She's in the hotel doing her quarantine now. Tomorrow, the cats are being collected. Then they'll be go through all of their checks and then they get sent over as well. A few days after that, the movers are arriving to take out some of the bigger things like my monitors, you know, clothes, that kind of thing. And of course, my desk. And then finally, once all of the critical cargo has gone, the final piece of luggage, me, I get to join them as well. Now, the video I did about selling my Nikon DSLRs, all true, but there was an extra motivation. I was at the point where it was time to sell off some of that gear, so why lug it all the way around the world with me? It makes much more sense to sell it to KEH Camera in USA, get a good price for it, travel light, and then in 2021, buy into a new system that works for me and, you know, a whole fresh start. If you want to do something similar yourself, if you're looking to sell some gear, whether it's to change systems or to just lighten your bag or to raise some money for the holidays, check out KEH Camera. They're great to deal with. You can get an instant online quote and a bonus 5% with my code. Link is in the description below. So where, when, why, how, all of that good stuff. Firstly, where? We're moving to Hong Kong. Now, I actually intend, once travel resumes safely, to split my time between Hong Kong, USA, and Australia, but Hong Kong will be the base for the next few years going forward. I don't anticipate there being any big change to the kind of content that you're seeing, at least in the short term. I have a bunch of videos filmed that I'll be editing, working my way through, and still putting out live for you guys. And it's not like my location has a big bearing on the kind of content that I make anyway. And of course, I do plan to catch up with Steph and Joe and the whole crew as often as possible when I get back here. The primary reason is to be closer to family. My wife's family are in Hong Kong. My family are in Australia, which is relatively pretty close to Hong Kong. And we have a lot of great long-term friends in Hong Kong. So for us, it just makes sense as a move in terms of getting a balance between work and life. To the question of why now, that's very fair. Why would you want to move internationally during a pandemic? We were always intending to come to America for 3 to 5 years. It's been right on 4 years. It might look like I'm following the US election cycle. I promise I'm not. We moved here just after the 2016 presidential election, and now I'm moving out just after the 2021. It's coincidental. I'm a big planning and strategy guy, and it's been fantastic business-wise being here. Actually, all of my goals, even as I revise them each year, have been exceeded. I was already planning to make some changes in 2020, and the lack of travel actually really helped me because it gave me more time not running tours to lean into that more. We got artnudeportraiture.com up and mattgrangerphotography.com, signed some new contracts, expanded others, and fortunately all of that will continue and grow wherever I'm based in the world. So it's not, you know, some political thing for why we're moving. Now, in terms of the friends I've made here and through business, you know, whoever I'm working with, I tend to develop friendships in each of the companies. That is a tough one. Now, fortunately, that's all going to continue as well. I've taken the time to have the discussions with all of them. So the forward-facing ones that you see, like B&H Photo, Lens Protego, KEH Camera, all great companies and all ones that I intend to keep working with either from abroad or when I'm visiting to the States. Now, in terms of family and friends in America, that's a tricky one, especially the team that you see on screen. My videographers, I will really miss the day-to-day interaction, but I will still be working with them on doing edits remotely. Johanna and Steph, I'm really going to miss. I have to say though, there was going to be big changes in 2021 anyway. Johanna has moved to LA and Steph is based in Philly and she's focusing more and more on her own productions and business, and she really doesn't model anymore except for with me anyway. So for day-to-day content, regular co-host type stuff, I would have needed to find new people to collaborate, whether I was in New York or in Hong Kong. So I still plan to work with those ladies when I do get back here. And I've talked to both of them about flying them out to Asia for some special projects in 2021. So hopefully I won't miss them too much and you'll still see them around plenty. So look, whilst there's some obvious challenges and downsides to moving, and it's been a huge amount of work getting to this point in terms of planning it all out, I'm actually really, really excited for the new challenge, the new opportunities that Hong Kong is going to offer, setting up a new studio. I'm setting up a couple of new businesses over there as well. I think it's a great opportunity to further grow the business and create even more cool content, loads of which you'll see here free on YouTube. Now, what you may be actually here for, cameras. Look, when I made the video about selling my Nikon DSLR stuff to KH Camera, I was completely honest. My intention was to wait until the end of the year, see what the different camera companies were offering, and make a decision that suited myself. Now, I hope it goes without saying that when I'm trying to review equipment, my goal is to be useful to the audience. Of course, I have my own biases and I try to disclose them and make them known, but I do still try to be impartial when I'm looking at a particular camera, whoever makes it, or across different brands. I was actually quite surprised how fiery the Nikon community was when I had negative things to say about them over this year, and then crickets when it was, you know, positive stuff. Having said all of that, in my heart, I'm still a Nikon guy, and I've been waiting and watching what's happening with the Nikon Z line of lenses and camera bodies. I have to say, their mirrorless lenses are all optically spectacular, and something I have to give them credit for, and Canon really, they have done really well in building out their lens lineup fairly quickly with high quality optics. You can look at it from people who love the first generation but had some small changes they'd like to be made. They're probably going to be quite happy, and that's more likely to be people like me. If the new software has really improved the autofocus like they say and made everything more responsive, quicker, it actually could be just what I'm looking for. I still love the body ergonomics of these. So whilst I do think objectively on paper, the specifications of the Nikon bodies are lagging behind the Canons and the Sonys as of right now in 2020, the ergonomics for me just work and they're going in the right direction and the lenses are spectacular. So I'm definitely leaning in that direction. And I do see that from time to time, some new Z lenses are popping up on KH Camera available to buy. So I'm hoping I'll be able to pick up some of those as a bargain if I do decide to go into the system. So that's pretty much it for now, folks. Watch this space. There may be a slight blip in content as I go through the relocation process. It's kind of complicated with the quarantine and everything, but I do plan to be up and running and creating even more free content than ever before once we're up and set up in Hong Kong. I now need to finish packing, spend some quality time with the cats, get them and the luggage off, get myself off. And fortunately, with selling so much of my equipment off to KH Camera, now my camera gear basically fits into a single roller, which will be nice for relocating. Reminder, if you're looking to sell any gear of your own, check out KH Camera. Links below. If you use the code MGSELL, you get a bonus 5%. You can get an instant online quote on your gear. Whether you're looking to switch systems, you want to just lighten your load, there's gear that you're not using anymore, or you want to raise some money for the holidays, they're really great people. I've dealt with them for a couple of years now before I started, you know, having a partnership with them. So check them out. They have the world's biggest range and they've been in the business for over 40 years. Hope you enjoyed this, folks, and I'll see you on the other side, literally, of the world. Cheers.